Today, the opening begins with Tipsy Cow Milk Stout from One Great City Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as having a dark malt character of coffee and chocolate notes and balanced by lactose, lending it body and sweetness. Then there's a story on the back of the can talking about cow tipping, which is always fun for us farm kids to talk to the city folks about. Okay, let's start small. This says, say, brass knurled nuts. Oh, okay. So these are little knurled inserts, threaded inserts. Does it say on them what size they are? 3X? M3 maybe? These are used for a few different things, but a lot of people use them to insert into a hole in a 3D print so you can run a machine screw into it rather than having to use self-tappers or having to thread straight into the plastic. Generally, you just heat these guys up on the end of a soldering iron and then ram it into the plastic. And when it cools, it sort of grips around the knurlings and whatnot and gives you a threaded hole. M3 brass copper metric threaded round knurl insert embedded nut OD 4/5mm. I got these from MK120 Service-TY. They cost me $3.74, and so I can't remember if they actually had shipping on them or not when I ordered them. It doesn't say that it's changed, so it looks like they did have. But regardless, based on how I do my searches and whatnot on eBay, this would have been the cheapest price all in that I could find at the time. There are a whole variety of different shapes and sizes of these things. Some are stopped, some are through hole, different lengths and whatnot. But the ones that I got were M3, 5mm long, and 4mm across the outside. You can get a little bit wider ones, and you can get ones that are longer as well, more like this one down here. Let's try one out and just see how this goes. Oh wow, that goes in easily. Okay, there we have an M3 metal thread embedded in a 3D printed part. Hi, next thing in says screws times one, or business and industrial on the back. Okay, that's not screws. That is connectors for a soldering iron, soldering station, I think. Yes, that is the connector, I think, for the 212 soldering iron. This one here. And I ordered those because you may remember a while ago I ordered this extra handle, this actual HACO labeled handle for the T12 soldering iron, soldering station, because the original one doesn't fit perfectly with a stand, but this one does. Yeah, that's the only real reason. But this replacement one came with the wrong cable. It came with this DIN cable, or connector, rather than this, I don't know, what do you call these, aviation connector or military connector or something like that. So hopefully that actually fits.
GX12-2/3/4/5/6 pin 12mm male female panel metal aviation plug socket connector. I got 5-pack of the 6-pin female, but you can get any of those. I paid $4.74, and back then there wasn't shipping on it, but these days there seems to be shipping on everything. Got these from Superior Buy 2014. Doesn't say much about them down here, other than, again, they're GX12 style. The hole size, or the diameter, is 12 millimeters. And they claim to be functional between minus 50 Celsius and plus 70 Celsius. And available in a variety of sizes and or genders.
Yes, it does. Perfect. Okay, well, that's a little mini project to take this guy apart, figure out the wiring, and connect it up. I'll do that sometime in the future. Okay, let's see what's in the crumpled box. This came from the drop shipping warehouse in Mississauga, so I don't really know what supplies it has in it, on it, but we'll figure that out when we get inside. This is two cheap carabiner type clip things. Says right on them, not for climbing, which makes sense because they're just cheap aluminum. But they are the type that kind of locks up. Okay. So the real ones have that too. Obviously, these are just for, you know, locking your gate or clipping your dog's leash onto something or whatever. But you see they've got the thread in there. And if you spin that down, then the bail can't open. The real ones for climbing and whatnot have that, or, oh, that's actually obsolete too. There's a different type of latch on them. And the reason the real ones for climbing don't use that anymore is if you got your rope running through there and it's pulling through, it can loosen it up so that the thing can open up. But again, for just latching a gate or whatever, that's fine. Don't remember intentionally buying two of them, but obviously I did. I think that can come off So the reason I bought these is just as a keychain or a key hook to hook them onto my belt. So I got a ridiculous amount of keys for work, and I like to not have to have them on me 24/7, just when I'm at work. So it makes it easy to clip them on and off the belt.
One times outdoor aluminum carabiner hook clip camping. I got these from, two of one times. I got them from Optimum Tech, and I bought them at auction. So that's how come I ended up with two of them. I put lowball bids on a couple of different ones, thinking that I might win one of them, and be damned if I didn't get both of them. So this one cost me 40 cents, and the other one cost me 41 cents. Whatever, for that price, they're cheaper than buying them from the local dollar store, which is why I was putting such lowball bids on them, obviously. What do we say down here? Not to be used for mountain climbing, rock climbing, high altitude sports. You will need special purpose carabiners for that sort of activity. Absolutely. These are just cheap, shitty ones. Material, gray aluminum, sure. For outdoor activities like camping, fishing, yeah, okay. With a spring loader latch and a screw lock. Can be used as keychains, and that is what I'm going to be using them for.
Hey, next one in. It says Burr Handle Tools. Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, this is a deburring tool. The brand name ones are Noga, I think. And machinists tend to use them for deburring metal parts that they've cut off with a saw or something. So this blade part here that spins around is ground to a sharp edge in the inside here. And you just spin it around the edge of your part to clean it up, either on the inside of a hole or the outside of a straight part. So obviously I am not a machinist and I don't do a lot of metal work. But the reason I got this is apparently they work pretty good for deburring or for removing sharp edges off of 3D prints. Kind of like this one here. We've got the little skirt on it or brim on it. That works fairly well.
New NB1100 Burr Handle Deburring Blades Cutting Tools Hand Tools from HMZKFUGN-4. Looks like he just smashed his hands on the keyboard for a while. Okay. Currently selling for $4.15. But back when I bought this, I got it for $3.70 Canadian. Anybody who wants to buy one of these or clicks on the link below, just make note of that. You may want to find a different seller. Deburring blade, manual operation. Two are adapted, sharp cutting edge for cutting, machining surface. Processed stainless steel, aluminum, rubber, plastics, etc. Yep, plastic is good for me. Angle of 40 degrees, whatever. Yeah, okay.
Here's a little cable clip I printed a while ago. And you can kind of see, I think, in there that there's some sort of flash or flanging left. even after I trimmed it with a knife a little bit. So let's just see how well this works. Oh, that's pretty nifty. Just run it along the inside of the part. Well, I think that might be worth the price of admission. Yeah, even if that is crappy steel, it doesn't matter because I'm just cutting plastic with this. I'm not knocking the edge off metal parts, even though metal parts is what that thing's designed for. And the last thing in, shipped by Royal Mail from somewhere in the UK. This is, let's say, caliper times one. That's about the right length for calipers. It looks like it is. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. It even comes with an LR44 battery in the package. Cool. So this is just a cheap plastic or something set of calipers. And the reason I got these is as I'm experimenting with designing stuff for 3D printing, I've discovered that it really helps to be able to measure the things that you're doing accurately. Now, I already have a set of calipers, also fairly cheap ones, but there's something goofy with these. You zero it and then run it out. It loses its calibration almost immediately. Like, look at that. That ain't right. That should be about 20 millimeters, but it's saying it's... Oh, it was negative for a while. Yeah, there we go. So, obviously, that doesn't do anything for me. Thank you, Canadian Tire. So, I went on eBay, as I do, and found a cheap set to replace it. And it can do inches if you want it to, but I don't want it to. It says that little screwdriver shank is 3.9 millimeters. Let's see if I can get an accurate reading off of this one in a small amount here. That also says 3.9. And it seems to work okay under about 10 centimeters or so. But beyond that, it starts getting funky. And sometimes it works just fine. But it gets really frustrating really quickly when it isn't working. I'm not expecting it to be a super high precision tool because it's plastic, but for the price paid, it's going to do the job for me.
150 millimeter 6-inch LCD digital electronic carbon fiber vernier caliper gauge micrometer. No, not quite. It's not carbon fiber, I don't think. It's not really vernier, but whatever. Got this from Acoming 868, paid $8.97 with free shipping. Resolution 0.1 millimeter, repeatability 0.1 millimeter, measuring speed, whatever, one battery, LR44 included. Not much else to see about it here. Made of strong plastic carbon fiber composites. We'll see about that. I don't think it's carbon fiber. If it is that accurate, that's going to be plenty fine for what I'm doing with it.
And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite the neat little variety of stuff. Okay, quickly, shipping times. 17 days for the cheap carabiners. The calipers took 25 days. These connectors took 32 days. The deburring tool took 29 days. And the little knurled inserts took 34 days. All pretty decent shipping times, especially for the stuff that actually did come directly from China. And some came from the UK. Well, thanks for watching. As usual, thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping me afford this stuff and buying me a beer now and again. I truly appreciate it, guys. Any comments or questions, as usual, down below in the comments section. I'll talk to you later.